Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform a logo or text into gold leaf and stencil it on frosted glass. You can use any image you want for your background. However, if you'd like to use this one, I provided its link in the video's description or project files. The first step is to convert your background into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively with smart filters, or even replace it with another background without having to redo any of the filters that we'll be adding to it. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. You know a layer is a smart object when you see this icon at the lower right corner of its thumbnail. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Distort folder, click Glass, and choose Frosted. I'll make the distortion 3 and the smoothness 1. However, if you're using a different image, you may want to adjust these amounts depending on your image's size and resolution. I'd like to soften it a little, so I'll go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 20 pixels and click OK. At this point, your image will look too soft, so we'll reduce the blur's opacity by double-clicking on the icon next to Gaussian Blur. The Blending Options window will appear. Reduce the blur's opacity to 50% and click OK. Next, we'll create a gold leaf texture that will apply to your logo, symbol, or text. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Click the background color and type in 87681E. Then click OK. Notice your background color is the color you just typed in. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. Go back to Filter and Filter Gallery. The same glass filter and settings that you used earlier will open. Click OK to apply it to the cloud's texture. Let's brighten it a bit. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Brightness Contrast. Click the Clipping Mask icon, which makes the adjustment layer clip or restrict itself to affect just the one layer beneath it in the Layers panel. If we didn't clip it, the adjustment layer would affect all the layers below it. Increase the brightness 40%. Open a black and white graphic you'd like to make into gold leaf. You can also use text if you like. If you do use text, make its color white. If your graphic is black on a white background, we need to invert it. To do this, press Ctrl or Command I. Go to Select and Color Range. Choose Highlights and click OK. This makes a selection of its shape. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the shape onto its own layer. Drag it onto the tab of your document, and without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the image and release. To center it, press Ctrl or Command A to select it all, and click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out or in. If you want to slide it up or down, press the Up or Down arrow key on your keyboard. Then press Enter or Return. Change its blend mode to Overlay. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of the logo or text to make a selection of its shape. click the thumbnail of the texture to make it active, and click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the texture. To bring more attention to your logo or text, we'll add an outer glow to it. Double-click on its thumbnail, which makes the layer active and opens its layer style window. Click Outer Glow. Change its blend mode to Linear Dodge and its opacity between 25 to 30%. Make the noise approximately 35% and the size 185 pixels. Then click OK. I want to lighten the shadow reflections on the gold leaf, but keep the highlights and midtones as is. To do this, first make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Control-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of your logo or text to make a selection of its shape. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the composite snapshot. Make the composite snapshot active and go to Image, Adjustments, and Shadows Highlights. Slide the shadow amount to 100% and click OK. Repeat these steps 3 or 4 times to increasingly lighten the shadows. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.